Oh, go ahead.
Hey, Luki. You've been at UNC 4 years. I mean, this game has, I mean, the last game y'all have won and y'all shot this low percentage was 1957. So, I mean, what's the silver lining in this? I mean, what good can you make out of the win tonight?
The good I can make out of it is it's an ACC win, and our goal is to be the best team in the ACC. And as long as we get the win, honestly, it's going to be some ugly games. Obviously, we know we got to get better moving forward, but we're glad we got the win.
Andrew Jones.
Steve just told us the lowest field goal shooting percentage ever for Carolina in a win. And to think that when you guys have had some poor offensive performances earlier, the scores have been not like tonight's, but a little bit on the lopsided end. So, to your point, you just said about winning, the importance of stringing together a win and winning a game where it was just kind of ugly and the legs were maybe heavy. Is that the kind of thing that can give you guys confidence moving forward, knowing that you can work through an ugly night like this?
Absolutely. As ugly as it was, second half we held them to 16 points. I mean, that's moving forward. That's winning basketball to me. Honestly, we got a lot of weapons on the offensive end that's going to get going here in a minute, and we're going to need them for Saturday. Absolutely. And honestly, holding the ACC team to 16 points is winning basketball, if you ask me.
How tired are you tonight?
I feel great.
All right, thanks.
Michael Coe.
Hey, Leaky. So a few games ago, I asked you about Puff, and you said it made your day to see him come in. Now, seeing him playing really hard, getting some floor burn, getting some standing O's from the Smith Center crowd, do you see him being a, do you see his minutes going up and up and up as the season wears on?
I'm sorry, I missed the person you're talking about. Are you talking about Puff?
Puff. Puff.
Yep. Absolutely. I'm happy for him. You guys don't even know the half of it with him. He's battled through so many injuries, since he's been here, and this year alone has been tough for the guy. But I'm glad he's out there. He's producing. He's helping us win, and I'm really happy for him moving forward.
Do you see him getting a lot more minutes as the season wears on?
I mean, that's on the coach, obviously while he's out there, he's impacting, the game and making good hustle plays. So who knows?
Thank you.
Austin Bean.
Hey, Leaky, being, a leader on this team, I was just kind of wondering, heading into this weekend, what you think the team, kind of needs to focus on to recover, after a rough shooting night.
I feel like just getting our legs back under us and guys getting back into the gym. Obviously we know what's at stake this Saturday, and I feel like our guys are gonna be ready, they're gonna be locked in, and I don't want to jinx anything, but I highly doubt that we'll shoot that low percentage.
Ross.
Hey, Leaky, kind of back on the rotation and playing players. I mean, y'all, all the stars played over 34 minutes for the second straight time. What do you think about how much the stars are playing versus the use of the bench? And the bench only scored 2 points. I mean, what do you think about that when you hear that?
At the end of the day, if coach is comfortable with the guys that he has out there, that's his call. And I feel like we're all battle tested. I don't think we were really tired today. Any specific guys were tired, but I'm not sure. I feel like we were all great. It was just couldn't get the ball to go through the goal, and that's just what it was for tonight.
Adam Smith.
Leaky, what do you make of the last two games where the shots haven't fallen? I mean, it was kind of a struggle against Virginia Tech to get some shots to go in, and tonight was pretty rough shooting. Like, what do you make of this? I mean, why is this happening?
I mean, I don't know why it's happening. I'm not sure, honestly. But like I said, we just get guys back into the gym and get the confidence back. I feel like it's just a confidence thing. That's all it pretty much comes down to it. Our guys are really aggressive on the offensive end, and they'll be all right.
You mentioned the defense, how good the defense was. Is that something you guys were talking about afterward? Like, all right, it was kind of rough go of it offensively, but let's look on the bright side here. Were you guys sort of emphasizing that in the post game?
Absolutely. Kirsch did a great job of letting us know A was an ugly win, but we held them to 16 points in the second half, so that's a win right there, and it's an ACC win, so we're happy on this end.
Thank you.
Yes, all right, CL, last one for Lee.
Hey, Leaky, around the 12-minute mark when Boston College called timeout.
What did he say?
Yep, disappeared.
Wait, can you speak? Can you hear me?
No, you cut out.
Here, look here.
Can you repeat your question,
I was
please?
On my phone. I was saying that Hubert got pretty animated in the huddle with about 12 minutes left. You guys had just gone up 7, but I think it just looked like he was pretty animated. I don't know if he felt like there was some loafing on a couple possessions before then. Do you remember the huddle I'm talking about, and what did he tell you guys?
He was just telling us to lock in. You know, the ball's not going in and that, but we can't get beat back door. We can't let them get second chance points. They beat us to almost every loose ball tonight, and those are just things we can control, you know, with effort. And that's just all he's preaching to us. You know, we can't control if guys are making shots or not, but he can control our effort, especially on the defensive end. So that's just what he was pissed off about.
All right. Thanks, Leaky. Everybody sit tight. We'll get Coach Davis in here in a couple minutes. You can raise